take time to realize that your warmth is crashing down.
Assalamu alaikum everybody and welcome back to my channel. Today we'll be doing a simple Eid outfit. Okay, so the amount of fabric you're gonna need simply depends on how tall you are. So what you're looking for is a fabric that when it's folded in half, it has enough length to suit your body. So for me, that was 2.5 yards of fabric. And I'm being very generous, it's probably just 2 yards. And what you're going to do, and this part is very important, ensure that your fabric aligns on the bottom. So then it would make it straight. Okay, so that's what it's gonna look like. And once you're done, fold the fabric in half again. Okay, now let's go and cut out our neckline. You don't want to cut a neckline that is too big, so I would say do not go for more than 3 inches. In fact, I would say about 2 inches. A 2 by 2 inch or a 2 by 2.5 would be sufficient enough to give a good neckline. In this case, it's better to go small than to go big, because you could always correct a small neckline, but it's really hard to correct a big neckline. And there, I have a little helper today. So the next step we're going to do is to pin the sides together so that it remains even. The type of fabric I'm using is a knit fabric. And it's not a heavy knit, it's a kind of a medium knit fabric. And if you work with knits, you know sometimes they tend to move a lot. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna clip those ends together. And if you guys are wondering, I'm using Wonder Clip. And now do that on both sides of the fabric. Now we're gonna put that aside and we're going to work on the 1 yard of design fabrics. Unfortunately, because of the type of fabric, the chalk wasn't working too well. So what I did is I got my yardstick. I left 2 inches out at the top of the triangle and then I cut. So what you do, you fold your fabric in half and you cut out the largest triangle that you could from that fabric. Alternatively, you could use more than a yard of fabric for this. Now, this step you don't have to do, but I did. I added some cuffs on my abaya. Cut out it would be a rectangle that is wide enough when folded in half to go around your hand. So there, as you could see, I have this rectangle. I have it folded in half. So there is a big piece of rectangle. I folded it in half and then that could still go around my hand to create a cuff. Take time to realize that I am on your side. Didn't I tell you? Now the next step is to locate the center at the of the armhole. You are going to sew up 2 sides on this. I didn't show it, I just wanted to show me pinning it, but I did went ahead before I attached it pretty much, and I sewed up 2 sides of the rectangle. No, locate the center of the rectangle and put a little snip. Do the same on the abaya also. The reason why we put the little snip is that we're gonna have to align the two centers together, and you don't want it to be misaligned once you sew it up. So now attach right sides together. Well, just attach it on the right side of the abaya. Because it's folded in half, there'll be no left or right side. Okay, and that's what it's going to look like. Now once I sewed the arm up and then I sewed the sides up, that's what it looks like. And as you guys could see, my abaya was just perfect for my hand, so I'm gonna have to do a little bit of an adjustment so that my cuffs could fit. But that's fine, I'll show you guys how to do that if you ever run into this problem. So the next step is to attach our triangle to make a beautiful design. What you're gonna do is keep the abaya on, or put it on your dress form, or estimate it, and you're gonna wanna draw a line. Nope, not that line, this line. You're gonna draw a line as to where you want it to fall. You could also mark the length of your triangle, as you see I did there. Now we're gonna take the abaya off. Now we're gonna take a yardstick, you could guesstimate this, or you could use a measuring tape, and you're gonna draw a line straight down. And that line that you're drawing is gonna be your cutting line. I do suggest you sew the sides up first before you do this, because the pieces could get confusing. So it's better to keep it all in one big piece.
Take time to realize that your warmth is.
Okay, so now that we have the abaya open, we're going to attach our triangle. I suggest you attach a triangle from the bottom, just because it would be easier to align once you attach it from the bottom. If you start from the top, you could probably have an issue on the bottom hem. And once you're attaching the triangle, ensure you leave 1 inch for the hem. Alternatively, you could go ahead and hem this before you attach the triangle. As you can see, there is my inch that I left on the end so that I'm gonna hem. This is the top of the triangle that I pinned, and I pinned it 1 inch further than the beginning of the triangle. Now I'm adjusting my arm. What I did, I simply just created a bit of a ruffle, and then I'm gonna tack it. I'll probably do a beautiful little design here, or I'll probably just leave it as a beautiful effect. But once you're done, go ahead and hem the top and the bottom, and you are done with your first simple abaya for Eid. Assalamu alaikum everybody, thank you for your support, and Eid Mubarak.
That simple, no, I can't spell it out for you. another, and we'll never find another. Just realize what I just realized.